sports. It's in the game.
Here we go, side. Right. Go. Side. Here we go, side. Today. 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 Here we go. Tonight. Go. Here we go. Tonight. 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 Here we go, tonight. Tonight. Here we go.
It's week three of the National Football League, and it's brought to you by EA Sports. It's the Titans and the Pats coming up next.
As of this morning, summer officially over. It's time for autumn football, and we're underway on EA Sports. And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. So here come the Patriots to take over on offense. They're led by their quarterback from the University of Alabama, Mac Jones.
And he's had good success here already this season throwing the football. Six touchdown passes in his two games. He's really got this offense playing with a lot of confidence, trying to establish themselves early as a Super Bowl contender.
Jones looking to throw right away. Throw left side, complete. That's Stevenson. They'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. They'll come up now second and four from the 31. They'll run it. This is Ramondre Stevenson. That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down.
A lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower the center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Throwing Jones. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. Now Jones. He'll get this into the hands of Stevenson. And they get to him after a gain of six to the 46.
I like it, I like it, I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're...
And the Titan defense steps up here, and down he goes. It's Jeffrey Simmons that time who got in to record the sack. So on fourth down, here's Bryce Behringer on to punt for the Patriots. He was called on three times in the win last week as his first one here's away. That's fielded at the 8-yard line. A nice return there of 11 to help mitigate a good punt. And it'll be Titan football. So the Titans set to go to work for the first time. They'll be led out by a first-round pick back in 2021 from Ohio State. It's Justin Fields.
Well, he did go 2-2 in the last ball game. Well, actually, he went 2-2-1, with the one being the victory.
Yeah.
That's the bottom line there. But wasn't it funny at practice? He threw one when we were watching through an interception, and the defense got on him a little bit good-naturedly, but they're letting him know you got to cut down those interceptions. We can't bail you out all the time.
Yeah, two touchdowns, two picks. But as you said, they got the win in that effort last week. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. A give running right, Gibson. And he goes across the 20 to the 22. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. But you look at this Patriots defense. They're a top five unit right now against the pass in the league. In fact, they sit at number five.
And I'm struggling a little bit trying to really categorize this crew. They're top 10 in the league against the pass, but the bottom half of the league in sacking the quarterback. That doesn't make sense. Imagine if this group ever put pressure on the QB, they'd easily move into the top five.
They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Throwing on third down, Fields. Eluding the pressure right. Complete.
That was their first third down try of the game, and clearly something was up in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
So a good punt, but a solid 12-yard return. And the Patriots take over. So back onto the field come the Pats for their second drive. Last series form a little disappointing, forced to punt, And now they'll try to do better here and come away with some points as they begin this drive, first and 10. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at the 40. Off play action, Jones. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Operating from the gun, Jones. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down. Now right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. Jones now to throw on third down. Blitz coming and down he goes. And the defense coming through on third down, a loss of 7 to bring up fourth. Here's Bryce Behringer on now to punt. This is brought in at the 21. A 7-yard return following a punt of 45 yards. And that will come the offense as they take over. The Titans coming back onto the field for their second drive. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went 3 and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys are a little bit jumping.
You
understand the same. It's just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went 3 and out.
And now they have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go 3 and out. I went 3 and out on that first drive. I'll try to do better here.
Here we go.
Here's a 2nd and 9 now from the 29. Fields steps away to his left. And a big loss here as he's taken down. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sand.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. He's got this complete to Williams. And he'll be taken down, but he does have 1st down yardage. A real letdown defensively. That was 3rd and a bundle, but they allow the conversion. On 1st down, it's Fields. Escaping the pressure right. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. The lines move there. Looked like nobody open. Now 2nd down. The Titans are 2-0 here to begin the season. And they come in feeling pretty good after back-to-back victories, CD.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience on display in that victory.
And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. From the 50, here's Fields. Flushed out right. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. Fields, we know he has the good mobility. He flashes it there as he scrambles for the 1st down. Here's Fields. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
And a pretty good burst right there as he'll take this down to the 33. 1st down, Titans, gain of 12. A much different 2nd drive here, Charles. They go 3 and out the first time. This time they've been able to sustain something downfield.
And that's what often happens. You get the game started. You know, you have to get your footing underneath you. You have to get used to the flow of the game, the speed of the game. And sometimes that first drive is more of a probing drive. It appears they found something here in the 2nd one.
No score after 1. second quarter now. Titans in possession of the football as they've got it with a second and four coming up. From the gun, here's Fields. Flush to his right. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 17-yard line. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
As he came to the line of scrimmage, he knew he didn't need much to reset the chain, so when he saw the space he needed, no hesitation. He went to the marker and got his guys a first down.
And he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
On second down, here's Gibson again. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the five at the six. 9 yards on the play there, and it sets him up first and goal.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went three and out.
They'll run with Gibson. A good run of 6 yards there. Gets him closer to the goal line with second down coming up. They're mounting a nice drive here. Good chunk of yardage there again. O-line, they've been solid this drive.
They have that look about them right now that says, if you do anything but run the ball behind us, you're crazy. They are really moved to well on this drive, and they want to finish it off the same way.
Here's Fields on a sneak, and this time he breaks the plane. He's in for the touchdown. Justin Fields, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Titans post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. Extra point by Patterson, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. And Patterson back out there to send this one away. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. And the drive starts with a carry by Stevenson. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. They had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7. Past the 30 to the 32.
But that last throw, Charles, puts him over 15,000 yards passing now for his career.
And Brandon, they're not going to stop the game and give him the game ball here, but that's still a pretty impressive number, and he's got plenty of more good football ahead of him. Although I would say the team should give him a game ball after it's all over.
Here's Bryce Behringer now. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time.
And it will be first and 10 as they take over.
The Titans offense now, they get ready to do battle again here. Things progressing to plan so far. Their defense has been solid, and they've got themselves a 7-0 lead after the touchdown the last time they had the ball.
And this is no time to even think about, hey, are we going to milk the clock? Hey, we just got good ball control. This is the NFL. 7-0 leads, they don't last very long unless you continue to push the envelope on offense.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Fields. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked up by the Michigan man, Jabril Peppers. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Patriot defense has a touchdown. Extra point splits the uprights, and we are tied at 7. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick 6. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. And here comes Tennessee as they get sent to take the field.
A Remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
Yeah, and sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, oh, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Now it's Fields. Nowhere for Fields to turn, and down he goes. They'll wind up losing 10 on the sack, and it'll lead to a third and long. Fields now to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. Give him 8 yards that time on the scramble, and now fourth down. On fourth down, Ryan Stonehouse on the punt. Fair catch called for in May, but now we'll have to see about the penalty.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker, defense.
That hurts. If it was running into the kicker, wouldn't be a first down. Roughing, it is a first.
And just think about the differences between the two. Running into the kicker almost feels inadvertent, just a small tap, so to speak. But when you rough him, here's your bodies are hitting the ground and flying all different places. And the difference is 5 yards or 15. And in this case, that's a big play.
I know he was trying to get the completion downfield, but the way this game has gone, with a few of the runs he's made along the way, he should have kept the ball and taken it with his feet downfield. That's the big play that shreds the defense. Instead, he thought to himself, I'm a quarterback. I've got to throw it. He bailed out the defense with that incompletion.
Third catch of this first half for him, and this one is a first down. Now Fields. The Pats are going to get there. Down he goes. Multiple defenders getting to him there for a huge loss. Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Back to throw, Fields. And his throw here is incomplete.
As a corner, you have to be able to run with guys step for step downfield in man coverage and make up ground quickly in zone. You have to put yourself in position to make plays just like that one we saw there.
Escaping the pressure right. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Here's Ryan Stonehouse now as he'll kick it away for the second time. And this will pin him nicely inside the 20 as it's out of bounds at about the 14-yard line. New England's offense set to go. So far, they've had 3 drives, 3 punts. Not good.
Not good indeed, because you've got to have something to show for being out on the field. Now, sometimes, if you have a game where neither side has scored, 3 punts isn't a bad thing. But when you're trying to set the pace, get up on top in a game, you've got to show better offense and find a way to put some points on the board.
So from the 22, here's 2nd and 2. Operating from the gun, Jones, and his throw's going to be incomplete.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it, sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And, yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. A run here with Chestnut, and he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play. On first down, Jones. Complete, it's Henry. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. Meanwhile, Jones' throw here going to be caught by Wilson. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. On the carry, it's Chestnut. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. And he missed it. It's no good. And this game will remain tied here in quarter number two.
And anytime you see a kicker trot out to try one from 56 yards, you know everything's got to come off perfectly for it to have a chance. If the laces aren't quite right, if he doesn't hit the fat part of the ball just right, it's unlikely to go through. And that one winds up no good.
He's airing it out for Williams. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
And they're not going to go quietly into this halftime break. They know they're in for a fight, so they're trying to make every possession count. They took the big shot there, but it winds up incomplete.
They'll roll him out right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away. And we will skip the highlight show this week. Get right back to this week three matchup. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Set and ready to go for the second half. One touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score.
And the half will begin with a touchback.
Out come the Titans now. They'll have it first on offense to start the third.
It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
Second half starts with a run by Gibson. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29. An extra corner comes on now for the Patriots D on third down. Here's Fields. Incomplete.
And so many times we look at the opening drive in the third quarter as a tone setter, and many coaches do emphasize it, and that's a strong performance there defensively to force incompletion and, more importantly, force a quick punting situation.
It's a 46-yard punt, 2 on the return,
and they will take over first and 10.
So here are the Patriots now. They get ready for their first possession of half number 2.
Now this game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive.
Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down.
That certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he get a good head of steam going.
And he will have the Patriots first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Operating from the gun, Jones. Now a short one to Gesicki. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion, and that will bring up second down.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans 23. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here. Now Jones on first down. He'll get this to his tight end, Gesicki. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave him with a
second and just a few inches left.
Well, that's always a good place to throw it just because he's one of the biggest targets not only on this team but in the National Football League.
And you and I both know the quarterbacks love these large body tight ends, and why not? Nowadays, they're really wide receivers who are just taller and have a little bit more weight. These guys catch the football, make big plays downfield. In the old days, we wanted them to block. Now coaches want to catch the football first.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. His second rushing touchdown on the campaign and fourth overall. And the Patriots have taken the lead. Extra point right down the middle. And that makes the score 14-7. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Here's Tennessee ready to begin this drive offensively. After that last score we just saw, now 14-7, so a chance to march down the field here, try to tie this football game. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it, but the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot.
Nowhere for Fields to turn, and down he goes. It'll be a sack and a loss of three, but more importantly, it brings up fourth down. They snap it to Fields. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. Oh, wide open, complete. Touchdown, Titans. Chigakonkwo, 74 yards. And the Titans' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Extra point by Patterson, up and good. And we are tied at 14. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25.
New England trying to get to place on offense. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. Jones' throw here taken in by Gesicki.
And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
Throwing again on second down. Jones, 4 yards to pick up, first down.
When the offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because there should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. So to speak.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Ball on the 40 now. Here's a second and 7.
Looking to throw. Jones. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Patriot first down. And as they come to the line, now in Foxborough, all square, 14 apiece the score as we get ready for the fourth quarter. On first down, they'll go to the ground attack.
They'll get it across midfield down to the 49.
Watching that play unfold and watching him complete it brought back memories of doing all those pursuit drills to make sure you don't over-pursue and let a guy get a cutback lane on you. He did that very well.
You praised him on tape yesterday for the angles that he takes to the ball. Took a great angle right there.
A field goal from this spot likely out of the question. They've got to get closer here on third down. Operating from the gun. Jones. Oh, no, he lost the football. And he's going to Titans 29-yard line. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but the other team doesn't get it. That's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
Here's second and 10 now from the 29. Off the play fake, Jones. And this is incomplete. Oh, that looked like a sure 6 points, but he could not get that to stick, and that is a golden opportunity wasted there. They'll look to throw again. And he's got his tight end, it's Mike Gesicki. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Excellent play there on third down. Give him 25 yards. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6. It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal. They'll run the chestnut, and he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Julius Chestnut, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Patriots answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead here in the fourth. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead is now 21-14. Fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. And the Titans getting set to go. And now after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. They'll start on the ground with Gibson. Nifty move. And he's got room. 54 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
Fields on first down. Flushed out right. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. The escapability in evidence there is that one. Good for 15 and a first. Now Williams. Gets a pickup of 4 and it'll bring up second down. To throw his Fields. Flush to his right. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Well, certainly those are the types of mistakes they're trying to avoid as they attempt to protect this lead late in the game.
And let's face it, they're hoping that this one doesn't cost them in a significant way. Yeah, one guy committed a penalty, but now the entire defense has to pay the price and try and rise up and overcome it.
And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. So it's the big left tackle who gets tagged with a hold.
And sometimes you're actually executing the block well, and he starts to slip off of you, and instinctively you reach out and grab him. And when it's done like that, it's often seen by the official and called.
And he's going to go down. He sacked back to the 24. Devon Godshaw getting in there and dropping it. This defense, they just continue to feast. 5 sacks now as a unit. It's been quite an afternoon getting to the quarterback.
And we're seeing it come from a variety of places as well. Sometimes just the guys up front getting to him. Other times you have extra guys rushing the quarterback, twists and stunts. It's been a variety, and they've had no way of blocking him.
Third and long, it's Fields. Eluding the pressure right, going for it all. And a huge mistake late, it's intercepted. Picked up by the Michigan man, Jabril Peppers. And the Patriots are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. New England with a first down as they begin the drive. Another important fourth quarter series coming up. That last INT helping to maintain their slim advantage. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. They'll bring a receiver in motion left.
He's going to get it on the jet sweep.
And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. Now Tennessee going to use the second of their timeouts. That's going to be their second. They'll be left with one more plus the two-minute warning. And we'll be back. Over the middle, he's got Gesicki, the big 6'5 tight end. Now the Titans will use their third and final timeout. That will be their third and final stoppage as they'll only have the two-minute warning now remaining. Throwing, Jones. He completes it to Henry. Room to maneuver at the 35. He may go. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. A great effort there. 68 yards.
And the Patriots are looking to make it two straight as they add on to this fourth quarter lead.
Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead now up to 14. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
The Titans set and ready to go on offense. But not an ideal way to end their previous drive. They threw the interception, Charles, after they had built up some momentum. They were moving the football, but something to at least build on for this offense as they run back out here.
Yeah, you're right about that. Up until that last play, everything was working pretty well for this offense, gaining chunks of yardage, getting first downs, really making a push for the end zone, and looked like they had a nice rhythm going. Now you got to have a short memory here. Don't focus on the interception. Focus on what came before it and get back to it.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
When you're leading in the final quarter, your radar has to be up for any potential deep shots. But probably not the last one they're going to see in this game, not as long as they hold this lead.
He's airing it out for Williams. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down. Fourth down, 10 yards to go. Fourth down, Fields has to have this one. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down.
Well, there's still hope, but it's dwindling fast. No timeouts left. They need two scores still. First and 10 here.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
These are running back numbers that he's accumulated right now. Received double-digit carries and has rewarded them by breaking the century mark in rushing, in addition to what he's done through the air. Definitely MVP caliber football we're witnessing.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
On second and 10, Fields.
He's got a man that's caught left sideline.
Here's first and 10. On first and 10, here's Fields.
Is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. He's got it, and they're back within a touchdown at 28-21. So that drive goes eight plays. So just over 90 seconds to play, and this would figure to be about as critical as it gets here. And this is secured by the Patriots. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though. Now this one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was